What is functions as a service, or FaaS as it's more commonly known as? Are FaaS and serverless the same thing, or are they different? Hi, I'm Jason Goode with the IBM Cloud team. I'm gonna answer those questions for you today. Before we go to FaaS, please make sure to hit that subscribe button. All right, I'm excited to get into it, but let's take a step back and look at a time before we had cloud. So back in the day, an organization would have to manage their whole IT software stack on premises. So let's take a look at that. So at the bottom here, you'd have your hardware, and this would be all your compute, your networking, your storage resources. And then moving on up, we'd have our virtualization layer. And essentially what happens here is you'd be virtualizing all those hardware resources with something, say like a hypervisor, to create modular virtual machines so you could horizontally scale. And then moving on up, then move into our operating system. And I'm sure most of you are aware of what this is. This would be the software that's actually on your computer and enables programs to run. And then on top of that, we run into our runtime. And this would really be the glue between your operating system and your application. It would be the environment that your application operates in. And then last but not least, we have our application. And this would be where all the magic happens. So this would be your business logic, right? And this is where your development team will spend most of their time because this is where they design, build, and deploy your application. So, as you can see, this is quite a bit for one organization to maintain and own. You know, up front, you have a lot of costs with your hardware, and you're not very agile. Say something goes down in this IT stack here, I mean, it could affect any of these given layers, and the time to revision and get your application out the door could take anywhere from a week to even a month. So not very efficient. So let's fast forward to the early 2000s, and AWS emerged with a new cloud computing service model, which is infrastructure as a service, also known as IaaS. And what IaaS does, it actually abstracts these lower layers, these infrastructure layers, which you can now rent from a cloud service provider. And it's a common model used today. So it's much more cost efficient without having to own and maintain these layers. And you can provision and get your application out the door much quicker. So we're looking at anything from an hour to minutes, which is a huge increase from that month to week timeline. So then we also had another cloud computing service model emerge, which is platform as a service. And as you can see, we even took the abstraction level even further with PaaS. So with this model, now you're just worried about your application. That's all you have to maintain. And the idle time is much shorter too. So you'd be running on at least one server, but you don't have to worry about your runtime, your operating system, just that application. And the time to provision and get your application outdoor is much shorter as well. So you're looking at anything from minutes to seconds. All right, so you're probably wondering, okay, so we're at the application layer, how can we abstract in further? Well, let me explain. So back in 2014, Hook.io emerged with a new cloud computing service model, which is the topic of the hour, and that is functions as a service, also known as FaaS. And what FaaS does, it abstracts that application, so now you can only focus on the functions. And the functions are the individual components that actually make up that application. So it'd be the individual tasks, you know, something like uploading an image file. You just have so much more flexibility and you have zero idle time, so you don't even need a server. That's all managed and taken care of for you by the cloud service provider. It's much more cost effective, and the time to revision with function as service is lightning fast. So we're looking at anywhere from a second to millisecond. So I know I went through this pretty quick, but hopefully you can get a sense of how functions as a service relates to the other cloud computing service models within this landscape. Oh, I'm sorry, I should actually take a step back. We should talk about software as a service briefly. So that's another cloud computing service model that actually abstracts all these layers here, including the functions. And you know, that would be something like YouTube. If you're watching this video, that would be an example of software as a service. So now let's take a look at how functions as a service relates to serverless and take a look at the architecture. All right, so functions as a service is actually a key subset of serverless, as well as backend as a service. Backend as a service is any third-party service that you integrate with your application. And the great thing about it is there's no code that you need to manage and there's no servers. So let's take a look at what a serverless application architecture might look like. And let's use an example of something, let's say a hair color for gray hair, e-commerce storefront, which I've never looked into before. Okay, so we'll start here for our client. And this would be our hair color e-commerce website. And let's say we have a user and they click and they want to see some before and after images. So we would have a request, come down here, and we would have a third party object storage service. And the great thing about this is there is no servers involved once again. So this would be one example of backend as a service. And it would use something like HTML, it could be JavaScript or CSS, and it would actually send those images back to the client. So now that they've looked at some before and after images, now we need to get them authenticated. So we can, again, have another third-party service integrated, and we could have this as an authentication service. Okay, so this would be one more example of backend as a service, but now let's take a look at functions as a service. And let's say that the client needs to get their account. So we'd have another request come, and this would interact with what we call an API gateway. And this API gateway would then invoke a function, and we'll call this function getAccount. And this getAccount function will now communicate with a different database, and this would be customer database. So this would be our functions as a service right here. So this would be one individual task within the greater application. So let's do another one. Say the client makes another request, and now they want to see, you know, what kind of hair color options they're working with, right? So we'd have another request, go through the API gateway, and this would have another individual function, and this would be available, if I could spell, color. Okay, so this function, available color, would go to a separate database, and we'll call this color database, color DB. All right, so this is, again, just a very simplified view into a serverless application architecture. And I mainly want to focus in on the function as a service functions right here. So let's just zoom in right now and we'll look at the API gateway and our functions and expand. And expand this out as well, the API gateway. So API gateway, it translates requests to a single endpoint and then routes it to a different functions as a service function. So in our case, our user makes a request, right? So we have get API color. And this API gateway notices the request and it sees the available color function over here because it has the available color route within the API gateway. So again, functions as a service is essentially small pieces of code written by a developer that are executed in the cloud and run on stateless containers. And what this means is that they do their job and then they disappear. And this leads me to my first key benefit I want to highlight, which is you only pay for what you use. Because unlike our other cloud computing service models, if you recall, you always got to pay for some idle time. Even with platform as a service, you're responsible for at least one single server. Another key benefit is you could just focus on that code, right? So without the underlying infrastructure, which is going to be a common theme, you know, throughout this whole video, is you could just focus on those individual functions from splitting up that server and that business logic, where you don't have to worry about maintaining it with that underlying infrastructure. Another key benefit is auto-scaling. So again, without that infrastructure, you can scale on demand automatically and instantaneously, right? So if your function as service platform has demand go down, it'll automatically scale down for you. And then last but not least highlight I want to mention is it's inherently highly available. So by being spread across multiple availability zones in different geographical regions, you can deploy your function as service platform in those different regions at no incremental cost. So I know this is just a quick overview of function as service, but hopefully you can now see some of the key benefits, as well as how it relates to serverless and other cloud computing service models. Thank you. If you have questions, please drop us a line below. If you want to see more videos like this in the future, please like and subscribe. And don't forget, you can grow your skills and earn a badge with IBM Cloud Labs, which are free browser-based interactive Kubernetes labs.